Hello, Willow Davis. How's it going? I'm doing a little new setup right now. Sorry if there's anything weird going on. I can barely even see my viewfinder thing or whatever they call it, the little screen on the camera, because everything's so bright. I hope it's all looking good. Anyway, we're doing a reaction today. Thought we'd give the usual folks a little break. Let's take a look at how Eric's Vlogmas is going. Good old Eric Cook. He's made the interesting decision of naming every day of Vlogmas just Vlogmas Day Blank 2019, just whichever day it is. And, I mean, I can't complain because he certainly gets far, far, far more views than I do on mine. So, doing something there, right? Anyway, let's take a look at Vlogmas Day 6, his most recently uploaded video. Okay, I'm gonna stop this right here. There's the sound of a gun cocking and being fired in his intro now. What is going on? This is, what is this about the reindeer? Oh my god. Where did he get this from?
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Eric.
Today, I'm just starting off the day, getting ready to let the dogs out. I need to do my hair. Need to wash my teeth. Need to brush my teeth. What was that? What are you doing?
Like the question mark block.
But today, I think we're going to start decorating the house.
Alex's
but we're
going
to wait
sheets.
Until Ricky gets home to do that. Chubb is playing with his little squeaky toy.
He's got the man bun.
I can't believe it's already the sixth day of...
I way back when, I had a tiny little man bun. It was only out of necessity for work. I don't know if I've mentioned that already. I'm confused as to why he has the man bun going on if he's never going to have his hair in a different... Like, normally you'd put your hair up when it's convenient, I feel like, and then, like, do something with it other times. I feel like he has the bun just for the sake of the bun. Which I guess he has the ability to do, you know, but I don't know.
Vlogmas. I'm feeling good going into this because I don't think I've ever completed a Vlogmas any other year.
Oh, wow.
So my stomach's been acting up lately. I don't know if it's how I've been eating or not, but I feel like I'm constantly bloated.
I feel like he's lactose intolerant.
I haven't been taking my acid pills in a while. So I actually took one today.
Oh my god!
Hopefully,
didn't he just get his like gallbladder removed or something? I would be taking whatever pills you're being given.
It does help my stomach. I've just been really taking my Dental, sticking to doing that because it helps my stomach whenever I'm cramping or bloated. Because we're
possibly
at IBS,
lactose intolerant.
So that's really been helping. Oh, I forgot to give you guys an update. I've been using that natural deodorant that I showed you guys. I bought. It does help with.
Man, one of the dogs is going to town on that water.
Well, I mean, I've never really had a problem with the odor, because the deodorant that I use always, you know, protects with odor, which I know stress sweat is, like, the worst, you know,
Eric,
for
be stressing?
The smell. But I've never really had a problem in that department with the smell.
Must be nice.
It's been helping with absorbing the wetness, but...
Absorbing the
not
wetness?
Not to the best degree that I would like, but, I mean... Which of the deodorants have I used that really has helped? Sometimes this I notice is... whenever I use clinical, like, it'll work for a little bit, but I guess, like, my body gets used to it, and then it stops working. I think
I have never had that problem of my body adjusting to my deodorant, I don't think.
Of really anything that your body kind of gets used to, it stops working as well. Just like with medicine, when your body gets used to it, it doesn't work as well.
Okay.
So I'm going to start getting ready for the day. Ricky and I are going to, like I said, we're waiting on Ricky for whenever he gets off. We're all going to decorate. We all want to be a part of it. And then I think Ricky and I are going to go shopping later.
Decorate with ornaments.
And we're going to do another recipe of a subscriber. I think the recipe is a chicken parmigiani. I don't know how if I'm
Chicken parmesan? Is that Parmigiani? Parmigiani? Chicken Parmigiani?
Pronouncing this correctly, but it's something like...
You've never heard of chicken parm, Eric? Chicken parm? Does that ring a bell? Parmigiani.
So that's what we're doing today. Be decorating the house, going grocery shopping.
Is that what he's making?
Do things for not only the recipe, but just around the house. And we're going to be cooking...
He's looking very elfy today.
A subscriber's recipe.
I gotta say.
So, let's get into it today.
Ew, what is that? That's gross.
It's a rutabaga. It is a like they call it a wax turnip or something.
Oh, it's because it's already got wax on it.
Ew. So, Ricky and I are here at Walmart picking up some stuff to... We're going to do hot cocoa tonight, picking up stuff for the recipe.
Bunch of dairy products that Eric will certainly not agree with.
The house. Like, we just need to, like, do for lunch. And
while we're here.
Yes.
Good old Walmart.
Ricky's looking very band director, high school or middle school band director. Like, honey, listen to me. Look at me. You didn't practice, dear. No, it's obvious. Look at me. You didn't practice, honey. Oh, that was a flashback I didn't need.
Let's check out those, see if they got those clear ornaments.
Oh, yeah, dirt.
And the pepper paint that I thought about.
What paint? For what?
Pepper paint, it's like you put it on something, like you can write with it, and it's a little squeezable thing.
Oh, I've heard of this.
It cuts up a little bit after you get done, and it's got to sit and dry.
Uh-huh.
I was thinking about doing that with those ornaments, like decorating them that way.
Oh, I didn't know if you just wanted to do the same way like we did them last year, where you just stuffed the picture down and...
You. The glitter that down in there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why?
Kesha's great, Kesha's cool, however...
Honey, you didn't practice your bassoon.
Not the rule.
Your house.
I played the bassoon.
Ooh, absolutely.
I played the farting bedpost, the bassoon. You knew that.
No, I did not.
Yes, I told you I was in the high school band for like a year. Not high school. That would be a little much. Middle school band.
I don't believe it for a minute. You're a
lie. The double reed instrument.
No, you did not tell me that. You didn't tell me you went to Disneyland.
I never went to Disneyland. I went to Disney World.
Oh, my God.
The double reed.
Ew.
I was never good. Womp, womp, womp. No problem.
I'm not sorry.
It gets all over the place. If it gets on my hands, I'm done. And it got all over me.
Oh, honey.
I was trying to be nice.
I'm done.
And I was trying... I'm busy.
I'm busy. I am busy.
Make sure that ornament got done for you.
Yeah.
So, don't say I never did anything for you.
Okay. Like, well, okay. Let's go pick up the rest of the stuff.
Okay, so we're back from grocery shopping. So, let me show you guys the stuff...
Ricky's hair is kind of lit.
The subscriber's
It's also kind of... Band director. Young, aspiring band director.
And it actually looks really good and promising, so I cannot wait to try it. And luckily, they picked...
Whoever sent you that taco soup?
Taco soup. Oh, the taco soup.
It did not take 4 hours to cook, even though it didn't. Thank you.
Yeah, that stuff was really good.
I like the Pikachu
knapsack
in the background.
Yeah, we're like thickened up when we put it back in the fridge about like...
Add some more cream cheese to it.
Oh my god. The stereo audio recording when Ricky walked around the back and now he was over here. Really. I was like, oh god, he's behind me.
Well, let me show you guys some of the stuff that we picked up for the recipe. Okay, so the recipe called for breadcrumbs. We didn't really trying to grab if it was just regular.
Bruh, you are making chicken parmesan.
So we picked up Italian breadcrumbs.
You've never heard of chicken parm.
It also called for fresh grated parmesan. So
you can say that right.
Instead of actually picking up some that was already grated.
I understand the problem. It's because it's spelled differently. Like it's literally like Parmigiano, which I think means it like... is derived from the region of Parma or something. I think. I don't know. So it's spelled differently than Parmesan, but it's pronounced largely the same in the U.S.
It's just, it surprised me how, like, hard it is. I was just like...
This dude has never seen non-grated Parmesan before, either.
It also called for fresh mozzarella to put on top of it to let it melt.
Okay.
It called for just a little bit of tomato sauce to lightly flavor.
So this is chicken parm.
Oh, lightly stained.
You're going to make your own, like, chicken parm, like, all the separate ingredients and stuff, and use a can of Hunt's tomato sauce? I would go a little harder on, spend a little more on the sauce, to be completely honest. Now I'm going to pronounce this wrong, and I'm going to be a total hypocrite. Rao's, unless it's like Rao's or something, that sauce, the roasted garlic one, it's like $8 a jar. Y'all, so good, though.
Flavored stained the noodles. Do we have olive oil?
Yeah.
Okay.
Got some great value, angel hair.
Then I think that was everything for. No, it also called for eggs to dip the chicken in before putting it in.
Oh, we bread in this.
And then you have to flour it or something like that. I don't know. I'll have to look it up and watch the recipe again. We picked up just some little Belvita cracker things just to eat in the morning.
Unrelated. I like how the mouthwash is called Smart Mouth. Like, you got a smart mouth, you better wash it out. I don't know.
We also picked up some stuff to do hot cocoa. We picked up some little mini marshmallows.
Your stomach will love that.
And we picked up some Ready Whip to spray on top of it. I wish they had just a smaller can, because I don't think we're going to need all that. I mean, unless we're...
Oh, you're going to need it.
Oh, yeah. Let's say just spray it in our mouth and just eat it. But I like the packaging for it. Instead of the regular can, I picked up the one with the snowman.
True.
Then... we were freaking out at the store because...
What?
I don't know if you guys ever seen that online.
What?
Or know what we're talking about, where you burn the cheese and it doesn't... What is it? It melts?
Oh my god, that like conspiracy thing or like whatever. It's not real cheese because it burns instead of melting or something.
It gets burnt. It's not
cheese. Oh, okay. He's a chemist now.
Actually, Kraft is not...
chemist cook.
Part of that, or... FDA made Kraft change that to, what was it, to cheese product, and Velveeta's the same way.
Biologist.
The only one that we figured out was actually cheese is Sargento, so I picked up a pack of that.
And we're also now a Sargento family.
Sargento family.
Oh.
Hillshire Farm. Go meat. Turkey breast. And then, as you guys know, people would suffer from acid reflux, kind of have, like, bad breath because where the acid comes up and can eat their teeth.
Oh.
And I've been having, like, a weird taste in the back of my mouth as of late, and, like I said, where I wasn't taking my acid.
Bro, medicine, could it
so
be the dairy?
I think that's causing, like, a lot of...
Could it?
Like, my breath problems, and it's eating at my teeth, the enamel, so...
Also, like, I've never smelled it, but, I mean...
It's just...
Thank you,
I'm
Ricky.
I have a taste of it in my back of my throat.
For defending him.
Doing you, you know?
And I grabbed the toothpaste of it, so...
Lit.
Fingers crossed it works.
Okay, so go ahead and tell you.
Oh!
This looks like I'm having a hard time.
What?
I am. It's half froze.
Oh!
In my opinion. All right, you guys. I got my water going over here for the spagooter.
Oh, Ricky Vlogs.
I got my oven preheating.
Ricky Vlogs.
And over here is the chicken pounding session. As you can see, I've cut the chicken.
Did you say chicken pounding session?
Chicken pounding station.
Oh, I heard session as well.
They had plastic wrap in the video. Conveniently enough, whenever you're at Walmart, you can remember everything but what you really need. We didn't grab any, so this works just as well.
Okay, so while Ricky beats his chicken.
There's a joke there.
Oh.
Ricky beats the meat. I'm going to start, while he preps the meal, I'm going to start doing the dishes and get them all out of the way, because it's not a lot, but, you know, they're kind of in the way. See, there's not too many, but I just want to get them out of her way, so I'm getting ready.
Amberlynn!
Put them up.
Did you leave those there? That looks like her meal prep stuff. Oh my god, I'm calling the cops. Oh, this is nice.
Okay, so now that the dishes are finished, Ricky has everything prepped over here. This is the flour, correct?
Yeah, that pairing seasoning's in
there. Were we supposed to put the seasoning in the flour?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I can't remember.
You're seasoning
the
flour.
So,
no, you don't put that in there.
No, I know. I'm just saying.
Is that a Ray Dunn cup? Why?
No one wants this.
I wouldn't be putting the egg in, a drinking glass, personally. Well, I wouldn't use the egg at all, personally, but...
Right? So, we add a little bit of basil to this?
Yeah.
I can't remember. I know we add black pepper.
Yeah. Okay.
We have some set.
Oh, girl, you don't have to... You can't be Caucasian seasoning this.
They didn't,
You can't be Caucasian seasoning this, as they put... Like, great value brand pre-ground black pepper and garlic powder.
Yeah, but we're not Caucasian.
Oh. Oh.
I mean, you know how I feel about pepper.
No, the breadcrumbs are... Out of
he denies his own whiteness.
I think we need to go rewatch the video before we continue any further.
How are you going to say you're not Caucasian seasoning this and you put free ground black pepper and garlic powder?
Wasn't supposed to happen. You're supposed to sprinkle the flour on top of the chicken, but you're supposed to mix the breadcrumbs on the plate.
Those breadcrumbs look a little pre-seasoned to me.
Add the salt Something and add the pepper there. To that and the garlic powder. And then after you add the flour on top of the chicken, you're supposed to soak it in egg, then dip it in the breadcrumbs, then bake it in the oven at 350 with the mozzarella on top of it and let the spaghetti cook while you're doing all this. So we're going to just try this again.
Okay, so there's that. Oh, yeah, we need the Parmesan.
Where's the grater? Can I grate it? I want to grate it. Yes.
Ooh, they got the whatever, Vegetti.
Which one do you want?
The Vegeta.
I don't know. Surprise me.
Zucchini. Okay. Thing. Oh, here comes Amber Lynn.
Ready to grate the cheese over this.
Oh, snap. What y'all cooking?
I don't even know how much to do.
Twinkie.
How much do you want? Is that enough?
Now keep it going, Eric.
Is that enough?
Bruh.
Ooh, girl, I feel like I'm loading this down with cheese. I'm gonna have to take a bento tonight. That's a lot.
Pop a bento. Whatever it is.
I think that should be enough.
You gotta think that there's gonna be four chicken breasts getting ready.
Oh yeah, in the video they only did two.
Okay.
Okay, so...
What is this?
We got the order wrong, but what you're supposed to do is sprinkle the flour on top of it and then pat it out.
I would... The flour on each side. You don't sift it.
And then...
What is this?
Do that on each side is you start is this? It in the egg. And then you dip it in
I've never time. Seen so layers of the flour getting packed in. Maybe I'm wrong. I thought you just gently toss it. Okay. Man, he done beat the hell out of that, didn't he? Oh, they ran out of breadcrumbs. I saw that.
Okay, so now that we have them completely floured, dipped in the egg, and breaded with the breadcrumbs, let's go on over here to show you guys that the spaghetti is done.
Okay.
Frying up the chicken right now. One's already done. Got a little toasty, but that's still good. Here's the other two. We're just waiting for these to get done so we can add the other one to the pan. The oven's already preheated to 350, and then we're going to pop them in there and let the cheese melt.
Okay. So, the noodles are done. What it's said to do is add olive oil.
Oh, no. You're supposed to do that right when they're done so they don't stick together. No. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. They already got dry. It's done. It's over. R.I.P. Oh, my God, you guys. Chicken parm, honestly. Okay. Oh, okay. All right. Oh, my God.
I don't know if people know what I'm even talking about.
Oh, God.
Do you need help? Or?
Well, this is breaking apart pretty easy. Giving me asthma.
So it's not even hot anymore.
Oh, honey, I don't have asthma. If you have asthma, God. You ain't gotta get asthma.
You got the chicken, you cut the chicken, you pounded it out, you floured it, egged it, breadcrumbed it, fried it in the pan. You're gonna put a can of Hunt's tomato sauce on it. Ooh.
Any more?
No, that actually broke it up very nicely.
Okie dokie. So let's add some basil.
I feel like there's a lot of oil that went into this.
I'm top cook. I like to just get my hands in there and get the hands dirty.
Okay. And then it says put enough tomato sauce in there just to lightly stain it.
Okay.
So
Yeah.
Yeah, what?
I don't know how that's gonna work.
Man.
Is it lightly staining it?
It's lightly staining.
Oh my god.
I've never heard of staining pasta.
I'm not staining you.
No, I would load that up with the sauce. Come on.
Well,
let's not be skimpy here.
The result.
I understand the concept, though.
Chicken's ready to be popped into the oven. I have all the Parmesan cheese on top of it. Now we just gotta pop it in there and let it melt. So I forgot to tell.
You scared the shit out of me.
I forgot to tell you guys. Yeah, I was sampling the noodles. I forgot to tell you guys earlier when we were at Walmart that we could not find any clear ornaments for some reason. I mean, they did have them, but they only had glass ones, and we're just kind of like, we don't really trust ourselves around glass. Ricky already broke one ornament when we were decorating the tree, so we don't...
My defense, seriously, I just like...
Oh my god, Ricky broke one of Amberlynn's ornaments?
Unhooking the hook that was already hooked to it?
Yeah.
She probably went off.
But yeah, we could
y'all actually need to respect really my stuff.
Spaghetti, Ricky already did his, but he took an idea. I was planning
he
on
hitting that Parmesan
on top of it. Give it a little more flavor.
You could, whoever sent you this recipe, I can go ahead and tell you it is going to be a recurring factor.
I think you could do a little more sauce.
This is going to be one of our, let's have some wine and
ooh,
light the candles.
Oh, you fancy.
Cousins or something kind of meal. But Parmesan cheese does not taste like Parmesan cheese whenever you grate it yourself.
Oh my god. They've only had pre-grated Parmesan.
Let's plate it and then taste it.
Plate it. There's not going to be a taste. It's just going to be let's plate it and eat. Because I can already tell
you. We got to show them our reaction. Tell them what we think of the recipe.
Come on.
Okay.
Oh.
And your consensus on the kneaders.
Olive oil.
We may have added a smidge much. Okay, I'm not classy. We may have added a smidge much to
olive oil.
Yeah.
Because they got
flashback to like.
However, that is so good.
Okay, so we finished eating dinner, just got out of the shower, and we went to go make some hot cocoa, and we realized we're a bunch of dinguses, and we picked up Swiss Miss, but notice if you guys catch
Keurig.
About it.
Keurig. K-Cup.
K-Cup pod.
Oh.
Keurig. We're idiots. We didn't even realize that we grabbed them.
Oh my god. Tell me they're about to give up. You know, inside the K-Cup is just some hot cocoa mix. You can open it up. And it's just hot cocoa. What do they think is in there? Bruh, it's hot cocoa mix in there. Just open it up. Oh god, are they about to give up on this?
Gosh, wow. So luckily, Amberlynn and Becky have a Keurig.
Oh,
so we're just gonna
thank
use that to
god.
Make hot cocoa since we bought this whole pack.
It would have almost gone to waste if not for a Keurig actually being in the house.
We just lucked out on.
You open it up and it's full of the hot cocoa mix. What do you think is in there? Hot cocoa grounds?
You gonna use your stitch cup?
Well, yeah, but you don't have a cup.
Well, just grab me something.
You call this?
Sure. We're new to this here newfangled technology.
Oh boy.
Hey, cubs.
What you think about that, Paul?
I think something's not right, Ma, because.
Lift to begin.
Oh!
Oh. Okay. Okay.
It's like watching two monkeys figure this out. Oh, no, you gotta hit the button, dog! You gotta hit the button!
I said ready.
No!
I said ready! Oh, look at me. Look at me. Yeah!
Yay! Woo-hoo-hoo!
Oh, you gotta put
it's lit!
That looks so gross, and that sounds
he's
so
in love with the cocoa.
That sounds so nasty, and it looks kind of funky, but hopefully it tastes good.
Hey, baby.
Hi.
Hey, baby. Your baby.
Aw.
The baby boy.
Oh, Chubb's my favorite.
The baby girl and the baby boy. He loves dance for camera.
My favorite.
Like, I'm gonna dance for the camera.
Chubb's.
He wants a marshmallow.
Not having
number
him.
One
I don't know.
Member of the household.
Hobbs not, but...
Look at him.
He's a little showbiz dog.
Aww.
I think that was their first time ever eating a marshmallow, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Did you like it, Doodle?
He you gave the dog's marshmallow.
Yeah, Trixie ran off with her. She's like, bye.
White so sugar? You gave him a marshmallow?
Little marshmallows in there.
Is that okay?
I have never done it with me.
Oh! Oh! What is that?
How have you never had
what are those?
Like what?
Because we had girls.
Oh, look, you can see the light that they've been using for the better lighting in the kitchen behind them.
Hot water.
Hot water.
Hot water, hot water.
It was a bad idea giving them marshmallows.
They loved them.
Is that okay? I don't.
Look at them.
I don't think you should give them marshmallows. I would never consider that.
Well. Ready to go watch a Disney
What
movie?
Is going on with Ricky's, the top of Ricky's
and,
thing?
Cool whip on it. Right?
The piece de resistance.
No, it's not fancy now.
Oh, snap.
Mm-hmm.
You loading that up?
No.
Oh, we doing whippets! We doing whippets! don't do that. That was... Don't do... I do not condone.
Well, after you guys seeing all that,
yeah, sorry about that.
You still have something in your mouth. I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog.
Seriously, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Thank you, Ricky. That's how you end it. Okay, whoo! Wow, nice to check up on what Eric and Ricky are up to. Little cameo from Amberlynn there too. How about that? Anyway, I'm really interested. Have they never heard of chicken parm before, or did they just not make the association that like chicken parmigiani equals chicken parmesan equals chicken parm? Is it not that common of a thing in other places in the U.S.? Because it is a staple around here in the New York, New Jersey area. I can't imagine it not being everywhere. But I don't know, let me know. And hey, I hope you enjoyed this. Make sure you're subscribed and hit the bell. Give this video a like if you enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time. Willow Davis, out.